Hello and welcome to another episode of Around the World in 8 Minutes with People's Dispatch, where we bring you news from people's movements and struggles across the world. Today we are reporting from New Delhi, India, where informal workers have gathered in the capital's Parliament Street. This call for Chalo Delhi or March to Delhi was given by Working People's Charter, an organization of informal workers of India. The workers here have several demands, all of which can be summarized into one demand, which is universal social security. This includes the right to housing, the right to food, education, health, and other basic rights which they are not able to get from the meager wages they receive. Purpose of this protest being held at the same time as the budget is being presented in the parliament is to highlight the fact that since India's independence 70 years ago, no budget has allocated sufficient funds to ensure the basic rights of those workers who hold up the country's economy and ensure its progress. The workers here are particularly against the anti-working policies of the Narendra Modi-led right-wing government at the center. This government with the Bharatiya Janata Party in majority has taken steps to dilute the already weak labour laws of the country. Workers in India have been facing very harsh conditions. Due to the rising unemployment, particularly in the rural areas, they are forced to migrate to cities where they have to accept jobs which pay them a pittance and they get irregular and unfair wages and have to accept poor working conditions. Due to this, they often get caught in debt traps in the form of bonded labour. Then they are not able to go back to their homes or look for alternative sources of work.
The government must determine 18,000 rupees as a minimum wage. These are demands. We are sitting here and we'll keep shouting. We'll be here the entire day. We'll sing the songs, we'll play, we'll shout. We have our speakers from across the country. And this movement will keep on until election, the post-election. We are not concerned about which government is coming to the power. Our demands have to be made.
In the cities where they migrate to, the workers are mostly living in informal shanties where they face a constant threat of displacement. So the workers here today are demanding their right to a dignified life. They want the right to housing to be a fundamental right. They want the right to guaranteed pension. And the women here are also demanding maternity benefits.
Thank you, Surandhya. In our next story, we take you to Ireland, where on Wednesday, more than 35,000 nurses embarked on a strike for better pay. This action is the second major nursing strike in the history of the country. Their demands include fair wages and recruitment of more staff. The strike was called by the Irish Nurses and Midwives Organization, the INMO. The striking INMO members withdrew from work for 24 hours, providing only life-saving care and emergency services. The nurses decided to strike after the talks between the INMO and government officials failed, and the Labour Court chose not to intervene. Nursing unions are demanding equal wages at par with health service grades like physiotherapists, whom they currently trail by around Euro 7,000 a year. The strike was fully supported by the union's over 40,000 members at 120 locations across Ireland. The nurses have been overwhelmed by the public support at the picket lines. According to reports, there was a massive turnout at the picket lines at various hospitals across the country, including Connolly Hospital, Crumlin Hospital, Rotunda Hospital, and Temple Street Hospital. Midwives at the pickets of Wexford General Hospital held up humorous placards with slogans like "We are having a midlife crisis," "Push Leo push," and "Make room in your budget." Irish Mirror reported Prime Minister Leo Varadkar's response to the questions in the Dáil, which is the lower house of Irish legislature, regarding the nursing strike. He said he could justify borrowing money to save jobs in case of emergency situations, but stressed that he could not borrow cash to fund pay rise for nurses. This statement led to a lot of criticism from Parliament members. The Communist Party of Ireland, along with various trade unions, have also expressed their solidarity with the striking nurses. For more information on the strike, we talked to Eugene Mc Cartan, General Secretary of the Communist Party of Ireland.
The two main issues currently in Ireland today, one is a major industrial dispute regarding 30,000 nursing staff. Also, next week there will be an additional complication in the health service where the psychiatric nurses will be also coming out on strike. The nurses in going on strike in Ireland today is over pay and terms and conditions. There's been a very sharp deterioration in terms and conditions of working people in Ireland over the last 10 years, decade or more, in relation to the whole austerity program instituted by the government on behalf of the European Union. This follows on from the forced, the Irish people were forced to take on board 42% of the European banking debt. And so that has led to a huge austerity program over the last decade, massive cuts in public health, public services, health, education, and various other services. So the nurses have suffered a great pay cuts, and so they are now involved in a case of trying to recover some of the losses. And we have to put in context that the whole question of Ireland, what is happening in this moment in time. For example, since 2013 to 2019, the nurses have had a pay increase of in and around 7%. Over those 6-7 years. While at the same time, housing costs, for instance, to buy a home, the price of housing has gone up by over 64%. And also the cost of rents, rents in Ireland now have gone up to over the same period of 6 or 7 years, is 61%. So you can see that we the cost of living in the forms of getting a shelter, getting homes, has gone really out of all control. That's because of much away of a great speculation in property speculation in the housing market by international investment funds, international speculators. They also, the nurses' organisation, have announced two further days of strike action this coming week on Tuesday and Thursday, and they are preparing for. To further tidying their industrial action. Last week, a number of areas were exempt from strike action by the nurses. The union has now decided, in order to intensify the pressure on the government, that they will reduce the number of exemptions further to intensify the pressure. This is going to cause huge difficulties for patients, and which the nurses and all that are very much aware of. But the level of public support for the nursing was absolutely fantastic last week. People come down onto the picket lines. We've brought them food and sweets and biscuits and things like that, and stood alongside the nurses. The campaign, the Communities Against Low Pay, a community-based organisation, also helped out on the picket lines. So right across the board, the government has meeting a widespread public support for the nurses.
Here is a group of nurses at Louth County Hospital in Dundalk, singing a protest song to the tune of the popular country song Wagon Wheel.
Pay me, Simon, like Dave H.B. Pay me, Simon, have we got a deal? Hey, 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 Simon, pay me. Pay me, Leo, like the boys in the doll. Pay me, Leo, cause my wages are small.
That's all for this episode of Around the World in 8 Minutes. For more stories and videos about people's movements and struggles, please check out our website, peoplesdispatch.org, and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Yeah.